Hello, dear viewer. Welcome to a commentary channel. And this channel covers every and any topic. Nothing is too hard. Now, before I get on to talk about today's topic, I first need to apologize. Apparently, I've been uploading videos, and because I thought they were quite harmless, I've said, yes, you know, my video is made for kids. Well, as soon as you tick that box and say, yes, your video is, you know, kids can watch it, automatically comments are turned off. So I've been wondering, hey, I didn't turn the comments off. Why haven't I been getting comments? Well, apparently it's just part of YouTube's community guidelines that as soon as you say your video can be for kids, comments are turned off. And that's quite reasonable and sensible. So from now on, I'm going to say, no, it can't be made for kids, and therefore you should be able to comment. So I'm very sorry that if you've watched a video and you have wanted to comment, use this video to say, Jem, I watched a video about such and such that you did the other day or last week and I was unable to comment, and can I please comment about it now? And do so, and I will get back to you, I promise. Now, I also want to let you know that I do not push you to subscribe. I don't believe in that. I watch so many and am subscribed to so many other channels where they say, if you haven't subscribed or liked, please do so. I'm not like that. I am not aiming for fame or anything like that. I get on here to share my views, to share my life, to hopefully help you from, say, what mistakes I've made, or to help you from something I've learned. And for me, YouTube is like, I'm doing all the talking, you're listening, so as soon as I finish talking, if you leave a comment, that means for me, you've heard what I've said, and you have a right to agree or disagree or comment whatever. And hopefully you will do that. Now today, I want to talk about romantic love, but I have again saved it to another screen. So sorry, I'm just going to swap screens so I can talk about it. So, the English misuse the word love. We'll say, I love my dog, I love chocolate, I love shopping, I love you wearing that dress, I love your hair, I love to go out, I love the sunset, and so on. So, we misuse the word love, and it's quite common in English to use the same term to express affection for various things or activities as well as people, saying, like I said, I love cake or I love shopping isn't quite the same as saying I love you, yet the same word is used. Other languages, like Greek, with its distinctions between eros, which means romantic love, philia, brotherly love, and agape, unconditional love, offers a more nuanced vocabulary. Now let's delve into romantic love. It's a profound and often transformative experience characterized by intense feelings of affection, attraction, and connection towards another person. Romantic love can be exhilarating, comforting, and even life-affirming. It's a bond that transcends mere companionship, often leading individuals to share their deepest emotions, dreams, and vulnerabilities with each other. Moreover, love knows no bounds of age. Whether you're 20 or 80, the capacity to love and be loved remains constant. So my experience as a 63-year-old widow underscores this point poignantly. I lost a beloved spouse, which doesn't diminish my ability to love. Instead, it highlights the enduring nature of love. It's a testament to its resilience in the face of loss and grief. The absence of a loved one can leave a profound void, a yearning for that connection and intimacy. It's completely natural to miss the warmth and companionship that romantic love brings. However, it's essential to remember that love isn't confined to a single moment or person. It's a force that permeates our lives in various forms, through friendships, family bonds, and even self-love. And also a pet. You can love a pet. A pet can be your soulmate. In times of loneliness, a pet. So as I navigate the chapter of my life, I have to remember that love is not finite. Though my husband may no longer be present, the love we shared endures within me. And just as I once found love unexpectedly, there's always the possibility of experiencing it again in a new and unexpected way. So if you are like me, a widow, or you have lost a loved one, embrace the memories, cherish the love you've known, and remain open to the love that awaits you on your journey ahead. So as we move through life's changes, it's important to remember that love doesn't fade away. Even though Rob is no longer with me physically, the love that we both shared lives on within me. And just as love found me unexpectedly before, there's always the chance for new love to blossom in surprising ways. As I said to you before, and I will say it again, and this is for me as well, hold on to the beautiful memories. Treasure the love you've experienced and stay open to the love that may come your way as you continue your journey. So coming back, so I am open to love. I am a widow, I am lonely, and Rob was my soulmate. But that doesn't mean I can't love in a different way. That doesn't mean I can't be intimate again. That doesn't mean that I don't want to have companionship, you know, to sit there with someone and to share a meal with someone, to share a cup of coffee with someone, to watch the sun go down and to go to bed with someone and have a cuddle and wake up and greet the new day, the new morning with someone. So please, if you have someone in your life, cherish them. Love them the best you can. The grass is not always greener on the other side. And you know, when love goes, whether it goes, well, it doesn't actually go, but when I mean when a loved one goes, whether that's a breakup or whether that's death, you are filled with remorse and guilt. Like when Rob died, I wished, you know, give me back. We had some really horrible times. I'm not saying love is all, you know, roses and sunshine. It's not. Love tests you. Love, when you fight and argue, love is put to a test, because there will come a time that you do butt heads, but you have to remember that you love each other. And because both Rob and I were addicts, and because of some of the trauma in both our lives, we were broken, damaged people. And when he died, yeah, I begged the universe. I said, I will have all that crap back if I could just have Rob. I would live with all that crap again if I could just have Rob back. So you have all this guilt, all this remorse. You know, if only I had done better. But all you can do in the moment is be the best version of yourself. And you have to, with love, you have to be loyal. You have to be kind. You have to be tolerant. You have to be respectful. You have to be open-minded. You have to be honest. You have to be able to communicate. But first, before you can love someone else, you have to love yourself. And I always say this, to be able to love another, you have to love yourself. And to be able to love yourself, you have to love another. And also, love is about being selfless. It's about giving, but not giving where you're doing all the giving. It's about an even balance. It's not about control or narcissism or anger or hate or revenge. Love is about give and take and learning. Yes, like I said, you're gonna butt heads, but learn from that mistake and learn compassion and learn to forgive. And if you've always got each other's back and you are always open to learn and open to each other and open to forgive each other, because we're all flawed, we all have mistakes, your love will last a lifetime. And the other thing is, there's this also myth, this belief that there's only one true love of your life. That's not true. You can love many people. I do believe that you only can love one person in that special way, but I do believe that you're still in love with the other people. You just love them differently. So yeah, I do believe in soulmates, but having said that, I believe animals can be your soulmates. Why do we have to confine a soulmate to just one person when we are part of many? When I is part of the infinite I, which is part of we are all one. We all come from the one source of perfect divine love. And when we say we love, we put conditions on our love. We love conditionally. We judge. And yeah, that's another thing. I'm just sidetracking here. I get really emotionally hurt when a pet of mine dies, and I've had many, many pets. Sahara is going to be my last one, my last dog. She's now 11. And I said once, why does it hurt so much? And someone once said to me, an animal, a pet, loves you unconditionally. And that's why it only lives a short life. While we need a lifetime, and even then, we don't love unconditionally. Maybe that's why it takes us, if you believe in reincarnation, many lifetimes, and still we don't love unconditionally. The only time we love unconditionally is when we go back to the soul and the source. And then, you know, we really do forgive. So anyway, I'm going to end this with every life matters, love, light, and blessings. And I hope you enjoyed this video. And as I said, comment below. It can be about this video or about any video I've uploaded where the comments were turned off. And again, sorry about that. And I'm still looking for an answer for what that orb was. Some people who've watched my videos said that it first appeared red and then it, like, there was a little white bit in it, and then it was yellow and then had this orange aftermath. I didn't see that. I just saw egg yolk yellow. Alright, thanks guys. Please do watch it. I've just uploaded it and it only goes for a couple of minutes. So I have trimmed the original video, but I really want to know. And because Rob was the love of my life, do you believe that was Rob's soul passing me as I was talking about rebirth? Thank you guys. Bye.